How do I open this? I don't want to. Oh, there's a lever here.
Stay calm. You're doing fine. Don't be afraid.
What is this?
I'm sorry to have to do this, but we have to know.
It's an eye?
I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this.
Okay, guys. Epileptic, look away. Time to remember. Yeah, I guess this gave people seizures or something. What do I do? Will I click it? Nosebleed?
You're a proxy now. You have a connection to the entity's inner core.
I'm a proxy? Oh.
It's like a conscious black box.
Transfer all progress.
It can show you its memories. Look into it. The visions will translate onto the screen to be something that you can understand. That you can play out.
Okay. New data connection ready. I'm holding the mouse. I'm Commander Shepard, reliving the beacon. The beacon on Eden Prime! You wake up in the cryopad, struggling against gravity, you force yourself up. Impact into the planet's surface has torn a hole in the ship's hull. Poisonous atmosphere spills into your craft.
Use the computer. Work your way through.
You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. I can barely see that. It's all fuzzy. Look around. I can't even see what I'm typing. The craft is broken beyond repair. There is wreckage all around. An airlock door is locked tight, and the computer terminal adjacent blinks. Memory retrace. Temporal interface conversion, it says. Well, if you guys can't read this, which is very probable since I barely can, just listen to me. wreckage. Airlock door. Terminal. Look. Wreckage. The ship has been torn apart on its final journey. Very little is salvageable from this. Systems are largely destroyed and unusable. You probably won't understand this. Systems... I've got this thing blaring into my frickin' eye. And my room is dark, so it's kinda weird. The monitor blinks, demanding attention. The system looks unusable. Was there an airlock? Is that what it said? Look at airlock? The airlock manual controls are locked shut. It requires a security override. Look around. Anything else? Airlock door, right? Computer terminal. Terminal. So this is like a black box recording the crash of this starship, I guess. And the alien memories are located inside this thing. And we are accessing it. The monitor blinks, demanding attention. Okay, look. Okay, not terminal, then monitor. The system look. Use, it's telling me the same thing. Use system. You tap at the screen and the airlock door splutters? What? Splutters to life. Oh, I can see! Oh, thank you. I didn't realize that if I hold it down, I can see better. Oh, too bad I didn't know that. splutters to life, slowly opening with a horrendous noise. The ship powers down to silence, having spent the last of the reserves. Okay. Yeah, this is much easier. Airlock. The airlock has been opened. The noxious atmosphere pours in. Where do we land? Earth? Exit airlock?
This organ was taken from what we think was the leader.
Okay.
These memories are different. They're not like the others. There's more detail here. Less hazy. Lean in. See what else it hides.
This is not what I signed up for, guys. God. If Jenkins had lived, we could have used him to access the beacon. That's all I have to say.
This is incredible. How are we getting all of this? It's describing the moment we found the ship. Mr. Asian, please continue.
My only question is, why is it displaying in the term of a text adventure? You squeeze through the damaged airlock and fall to your knees on the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. You look around to see you are surrounded by mangled metal. Bright lights pour through every gap in the surrounding wreckage. Look, okay, first of all, every noun, look at. So we got a vehicle. Metal. And lights and wreckage. Memory action unavailable. Look object not recognized. Really? Look lights. The lights are blinding. You can make out silhouettes, but you will need to move some of the surrounding wreckage for a better view. Okay, so that's just a basic, like, memory action unavailable, command not recognized. So this is our little error. It has a different error message. That's what that is. So I can't look at the vehicle. We can look at metal? Probably not. Move wreckage. With every ounce of your remaining strength, you move away enough of the wreckage for you to carefully crawl through. The lights that surround you now attack your senses. You squint at the light, trying to shield your visor lens at the same time. It is a circle of artificial lights set up around you to illuminate the crash site and all the darkness. Behind them, an army of people, all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks toward you. Okay, these aliens landed on Earth, and this is, I'm guessing, the military. One figure steps out, who I guess is in either a scientist or someone, you know, a major or someone in charge of the military force here. So we got a light, we got a visor lens, which I probably can't look at. Unofficial lights, crash site. Gonna type lens. Look, visor lens. Okay. Look. Sight. Nope. Okay. Look at people. No, we can't look at the people. Look at the army. Army, no. Okay. Let's look at the figure. Silhouette, figure. The silhouette is bipedal and bulky. Some sort of mask covers its face. It beckons you to approach. You really can't do anything. Okay. Can I use that verb? Approach? Go to figure.
Your heart rate is elevated, but you're doing well.
Oh, I thank you.
for what it's worth, very few of our test subjects ever make it this far.
That's reassuring.
You should be proud of yourself.
Okay. So proud. So proud. Oh, so proud. Dr. Daniel something. And I saw the figure. Well, it's an army, so they tortured the hell out of it, didn't they? We awake. The room is silent only for the quiet hum of equipment and occasional machine beep. Your touch isn't yours. We are all as one. We move together in unison. Okay. So there's more than one of us, and we move in unison. Look at the machine. The screen didn't give anything away, flashing symbols and what could be numbers in rhythm. Let's try our handy look around. We are in a bed, in a small and artificially lit room with a single door. There is some sort of writing pinned to the wall. Adjacent is a display monitor with wires that drape...
This doesn't matter. We didn't put this entity in quarantine. It expired at the crash. Whose memories are these? When did this happen?
Don't ask me, dude. I just work here, or volunteer here, or something. Yeah, there's some sort of writing pinned to the wall. Adjacent is a display monitor with wires that drape across the room and into our chest. They have tortured us. Well, apparently this is the collected consciousness and memories of all of them. Let's see if I can look at anything in here. We got a bed, a room, a door, we got writing, we got a monitor, wires... A cushioned horizontal surface. On each side, a metal or alloy barrier, presumably to stop you falling out. I bet you this won't work. Alright, look at door. The door in the corner looked atmospherically sealed shut. Okay, looked. Past tense, interesting. Look at room. I was just gonna... Yep, it's gonna play again. Look at us. No. Look at wires. A series of wires leave the machine and run across your chest, attached in different places. We aren't sure if the black fluid is going in or coming out. Collective discomfort. Did I look at the machine? Yes, I did. Look. Fluid. The fluid looks thick and dark. We can feel a transfer, but not which direction. Reminds me of the X-Files episode with the fluid that goes in, you can see clouding in people's eyes. The oil, the black oil. Those are awesome episodes. I want to get back to there's writing on the wall. And there's a monitor. So look at wall or writing. Look at writing. Stuck together are a series of flat sheets with symbols across them. Some sort of writing. Probably the English language. Like, this is completely blind, guys. If I'm guessing this right, I am guessing this right because the guy talking about this whole scenario is some kind of English guy. So look finally at the monitor. The screen didn't give anything. Alright, what do we do now? Get up. Command not recognized. Exit. We can't reach the door, effectively tethered to the machine. wires. Alert.
What's that alarm?
We yank at the wires, okay, protruding.
There's been a disconnection in quarantine lab 15.
From our chest.
Find out what's going on.
Together, we all scream in pain. This action sets off an alarm, echoing loudly down the adjacent corridor. And just like that, things are happening in real time from what we're doing. Alright, now can I get up? Oh, I can exit. Exit. Let's look at the monitor to see if anything changed on the monitor. The screen was blank, other than a red symbol flashing in the center, registering the wires being disconnected. Alright, let's just exit.
Doc, specimen 20 has left lab 15. It's on the move.
My god. That vision. It's not a memory, it's happening right now. Mr. Asian, I need you to stop what you're doing, please.
Never. I will free the Reticulan race. I am one of them now. Oh wow. We're in a... Oh! Who was that girl? And we were in a car that crashed. Sorry guys. Okay, the girl, I'm betting, was the guy's sister from the previous, from the house abandoned. I bet you that was his sister. And what happened when we went to the house, the second time where things turned all horror, we had to wrench our way out of the car. I mean, we had somehow crashed into the house or something. I guess killing our sister and we're getting a memory of that somehow. Through the door, we find ourselves in an empty room with a device on the table. It looks familiar. They don't know how it works, but this host does. The door closes behind us and a lock clamps shut. We are alone / together. Alright, I'll just look at the door just to see. There are two doors. The one we came in through and an entrance to another area. Both are locked. Obviously, we want to look at the device, but I'm just trying to see if there's anything else. It is some sort of preparation room. There are markings on more sheets with a door and a window on one side. The door we came through has been locked shut, and the other door had an orange alarm light above it. In the center of the room, a table holding only a small device taking from your It's My Our ship. Sheets. Look. Writing? Well, they call it markings. Look. Markings? Never mind. Look at the window. Thick glass, almost mirrored, on one wall next to the door. In the next room, a human is connected to a sphere by its eye. He must come too. That's me. Look at the sphere. No. Look at the human. Humna. Nope. The alarm light? That's not gonna reveal anything, right? Nope. Okay, so look at the device. It was an access code terminal for a wide connection, allowing commanders to commandeer other hosts. Only you, we have access to these codes. It's time to use them. Let me guess, 1986, use device?
What is that? You haven't seen that before. What is it doing?
Nothing yet.
It's using the tool we recovered from the crash site. It's in our systems. It's sending something across the network. It's broadcasting.
Mr. Asian, please. We deeply regret what we've put you through, but please understand
now you do.
For the greater good. We had to know more. Rebelling now could be catastrophic. We don't know what this might do to you in the long run.
Yeah, and neither did you, so we gotta match these glyphs. Arrow keys left, right, here. Do we just have to... okay. Because this looks like this glyph. But I can only change the ones on this side. Well, maybe I have to match these two glyphs on the right. Oh, I can't. That glyph's not available. Or am I supposed to be looking at this? Select row. This. I don't know. Looks like it, right? This. But I don't know what the glyph... This other glyph next to the one I'm changing has to do with both of them together, obviously, but... This looks like two of them. It looks like double. Unless this is one and this is the other one? Really hard to see, first of all. I'm not sure. Okay, I'm not sure. I'm just like, no idea. Oh. It's telling me there, isn't it? So I gotta match. We're looking for that. It flashes by so quick, though. Okay, this one is this. So I guess I've been like a little quiet because I'm not sure. This looks like it has a square. I think that? Yeah, I could see how people would be freaking out. I don't have to hold it down either. Definitely don't want to zoom in. I'd like to zoom out, actually. It's really hard for me to see. Okay, next one. Got a long, like that one. I think... I need to see it again, it's just too much. No, it's not that one. This, I think? That is just really difficult for me to even look at. I think it's that one. And finally, this other long one. That one has this on top of it. I think I got it.
It's over.
That's right, baby, we're coming for you. How many spheres? They all survive in these things. I'm going home. Probably. So yeah, I know these are longish episodes. Like this one's almost an hour. But I don't know. I'm thinking to keep them all in one episode. Because, I don't know, it's just lame to cut it out in the middle, isn't it? I think so. Cool. So stay tuned for next episode when we see the station process. And we'll check that out. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.